Hi, I'm Patrick. Welcome to Tech Edge. Science fiction has been promising us digital versions of ourselves for a long time. We're still waiting for Ready Player One-style virtual avatars, but digital simulations of real-world objects, devices, and even cities are already here. Today I'm going to give you an overview of digital twins, what they are, and how they're used. So let's get into it. First, the basics. A digital twin is a virtual version of a physical object, process, or location that serves as a real-time digital counterpart. Digital twins are built by gathering all of the information and data about really anything of which you want to make a copy, and then recreating it in a digital space. Digital twins help make complex, costly, or even dangerous processes safer, more affordable, and more achievable. They're one of the key enabling technologies that's making digital transformation possible. Building digital twins is far from simple, but once created, they offer nearly limitless potential. Every individual component, the ways those components interact, and even the environment they exist in are digitally replicated. The digital twin then uses artificial intelligence to simulate the effects that changes in design, process, time, or conditions would have, all without ever having to subject the real-world object to those same changes. Would you like to see what impact 120-degree weather might have on the performance of your jet engine, but you don't want to risk flying one through the desert? Just increase the temperature on the digital twin, and you can observe the result virtually, modify its performance, and increase your success rate in the real world. Interested to learn if changing the maintenance schedule for your factory full of laser cutting machines will have a positive or negative impact on production? If you've built a digital twin of your facility, simply change the schedule there and find out. Let's say you're trying to optimize the traffic pattern around a new stadium being built downtown. Adjust traffic light timing, one-way street direction, or intersection design on the digital twin of your city and analyze the results. In a digital twin, sensor information from the real world is continuously gathered throughout the development, production, and operation, and fed to digital twin models. With the constant flow of data, changes made in the real world are reflected in the digital twin, allowing it to evolve as the project does. Digital prototypes can be created, tested, and refined during development, well before creating a physical product. When a product does move to production, digital twins can be used to refine the process based on real-time feedback from the equipment and operators. Once a product is in the field, its operation can be optimized by using the digital twin of that object to help inform everything from the best possible operating conditions and maintenance schedules to proposed design changes or alternate configurations. So that's your super high-level overview of digital twins. If you'd like to dive deeper into the subject, we've had a chance to discuss digital twins with our partners at Intel and Inductive Automation during our OnLogic Live series. You can find that link in the description. Have a question about digital twins? Let us know in the comments. If you found this video helpful, we'd really appreciate it if you give it a like and consider subscribing. If there are topics you'd like us to cover here on Tech Edge, let us know as well. Well, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.